The TCM is a lightweight, portable eddy current device with a large touchscreen that can perform flaw testing and connectivity measurement in a single instrument. Today, we will take a step-by-step look at crack testing with a TCM. With a device, you can detect even the smallest cracks up to a depth of 0.1 mm manually. In a semi-automated setup, you can even detect a fault depth of just 30 micrometers. We will start by switching the device on, show you the settings, and demonstrate two crack tests. The device is switched on-off using the on-off button on the top of the device. Press and hold the button for approximately 1 second, then release it. After the operating system has started, the device displays the start screen, where the respective application can be launched. The test probes are connected to the TCM via shielded connection cables. Carefully insert the silver metal plug into the socket of the test probe. The test probe can also be connected after switching on and changed during operation. The Defectoscop App is the standard program for conventional eddy current testing and mainly used for applications like surface crack testing, borehole inspection with rotating probes, and residual wall inspection. To open the Defectoscop program, tap on the icon. An overview of presets appears. I select the default preset. The Defectoscop App allows universal eddy current testing to be performed. A wide variety of sensors can be used to solve a wide variety of testing tasks. Today, we want to perform a crack test on an aluminium crack standard and an aircraft wheel rim. For this, I use a standard absolute probe. To protect the probe, we recommend using a self-adhesive PDFE foil. Now let's set up the testing setup correctly. For optimal adjustment of the eddy current signal, we recommend using the following frequencies as a starting point for eddy current testing. This does not represent the optimal solution, but it serves as a solid starting point. The objective of frequency adjustment in mobile eddy current testing is to achieve the greatest possible phase separation between interference signal, the liftoff, and the useful signal. We want to test on an aluminium plate, so we start with 500 kHz. I place the probe on a fault-free area of the test object and press 0. When the probe lifts off, the liftoff is visible. I want to position it so that it runs horizontally. To do this, I freeze the screen using the snowflake icon when the liftoff appears. Using phase, I can now move the liftoff so that it runs horizontally. Now the crack signal is in the Y direction. This already looks quite good. Now I'm changing the frequencies to see if these provide better signals. First, I change to 100 kHz. Adjust the phase. And Ted, have a look at the signal height. Now I change to 1 MHz. Adjust the phase. And have a look at the signal height. And we see that we had the best results at 500 kHz. We would like to detect a 0.5 mm deep crack. In the moment, the crack signal stays below the 60% threshold. With the gain function, I can change the height of the signal. I freeze the crack signal again using the snowflake signal and increase the gain. With a gain of 14 dB, the threshold is exceeded. I've shown you the settings in the standard XY view, also called the impedance plane view. In addition to this view, there's also the T view, which shows you the values broken down by time. The combined XYT view shows you both diagrams in parallel. Now I will show you crack testing in a real-life example. There are some 0.5 millimeter cracks on the surface. I leave the settings as they are and place the probe on the surface. I press zero and move the probe along the surface. Here I can see the clear crack signal. This concludes our crack test with the TCM. For additional technical demonstrations and detailed product insights, please explore our other videos on this channel. Subscribe to stay informed about our latest testing procedures and solutions.